rogue wave came out of nowhere. With no warning, a 40-foot wall of solid water hit us like a freight train and was gone before we knew it. Suddenly, we were upside down, with water flooding through the companionway.
That's about as good as we want to get it.
Rick! Rick! What are you doing?
Emergency pick.
Come on, Phil.
I can't go, Nick.
Come on, Phil. Get in.
What now? What the fuck do we do now?
Yeah, eat.
We're gonna die. We're rooted.
Shut the fuck up.
She's gonna break up. Sooner or later, a storm or a container ship, we're going down.
Just keep calm, okay? Mm. That's the main thing. We'll be all right.
We just started this thing the right side up.
Can't. Impossible.
Why not?
Once a multi-hull capsizes, it stays that way.
Fucked on the drawing board. Bloody death traps.
Oh, we rig something up, make the masks, sail upside down.
She's 75% underwater, all right? Unnavigable. Hey. We got food. We got water. I got tanks full of it, thousands of liters. We just have to wait. We'll be okay. I want you guys to relax.
The only way forward was to adapt, learn to survive. They needed to accept the situation and go with it. But all they could think about was rescue.
Escape hitch.
Now someone's gonna hear us, right?
How long before someone picks up a signal, you reckon?
Hard to say. Not too many boats out here. Have to be a plane.
Well, how close they have to be to pick up a signal?
Depends on the conditions.
I'd missed my scheduled departure date. My original crew had dropped out at the last minute, and I needed to find replacements at short notice.
Jim, check it out.
I wanted to sail before the weather changed.
John Glenny.
Jim, pleased to meet you.
Yeah, good to meet you.
Oh.
So what's the weather like in Tonga this time of year?
Ah, it's tropics, mate, you know. Sun, warm beaches, more beautiful women you can shake your stick at.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah, friendly islands. Could do with a cook. Got any sailing experience?
Absolutely none.
Some.
Oh, well, you know, it doesn't matter. I just need extra bodies to keep watch.
How long would it take?
2 weeks tops. Trade winds are pretty strong this time of year.
You guys should come on down. Check it out.
Sure. Could be just what you need, mate. Hey, get away for a bit. Time to think. Clear the air.
What about you?
Maybe.
Seriously?
Sure. Why not? Doctor phoned this morning. Gonna see her tomorrow, but, looks like I'm in the clear. Latest scan says it's retreating.
Fantastic, man. Fantastic.
Rose and Will leaving 2 days' time. What do you reckon?
Go on. Write them down.
Come on, Martha. Don't do this.
I mean it. Write them down.
What?
The people I'll have to get in contact with when you drown.
For Christ's sake, have some faith.
You've never been to sea in your whole damn stupid landlocked life. You can barely swim.
We decided to take a break to see if this is what we really want.
Not that kind of break. That guy's gonna have you cooking from dawn till dusk. That is, when you're not throwing up, you get seasick in a kayak.
Look, I'm sorry I can't be on call for you, but I really need to do this.
Not your last will and testament, just a name and phone number in the States. Don't forget that. You'll need it. I'll wait in the car.
I was out of pick a moment, didn't she? Bloody air of departure.
I suppose. Oh, you know Martha. She's probably just thinking of the worst that could... Neither of us exactly keen on this idea. But it's good you're going. It's important. No regrets, all that. We'll say goodbye here.
Well, you don't want to come down?
No. I'm not big on public farewells, and it looks like Martha's in one of her moods. So. Be careful. Don't fall overboard.
I won't. See you in a couple of weeks.
Bye-bye.
Oh, this is going to be so good for him. See you, Dad!
Bye, Dad!
Us girls, we'll look after each other. Where's your mate? Is she all right? Oh, come on, cheer up. They'll be fine. Just think of all the fun you'll have when you get him back. He'll be hot to trot.
No, it's not that. We're breaking up.
Hey Jim, you full of ham and fenders?
I'd waited a long time for this adventure. Unfortunately, I wasn't sharing the first leg of the voyage with the men I wanted, but at least I had a crew. Once we made landfall in Tonga, I would replace them. This voyage was going to take me back to my old cruising haunts of the South Pacific. New beginnings, a fresh start, love and adventure. I'd invested everything I had in Rose Noel. She was my pride and joy, my home, my haven.
What do you reckon, Jim? Jim looks a bit green around the girl.
He'll be right.
It's all yours, mate.
Right? Yeah, okay.
Extended marine forecasts for all of New Zealand until the 6th of June. An intense tropical cyclone is situated off the east coast of the North Island, with southwesterly gales gusting to 50 knots and seas rising to 6 metres. For all of the east coast, Cape Breton to Palliser, including East Bank. Severe weather warning. For all of the west coast, from Kiribati to Cape Egmont.
This was music to my ears. There'd be no beating into the wind. We'd sail on a broad reach all the way to Tonga and make faster time than I'd hoped.
How's it go?
No. Looks like he's putting up more sail.
The plane would have to be close, within 100 nautical miles.
Come on, John, honestly, how long before they find us?
What you gonna remember of me? Of us?
John, 5 days.
It's okay, mate. 5 days and we'll be out of here. According to the Oracle.
I estimated our position to be about 140 miles off the east coast. The EPIRB signal was well outside the reach of domestic aircraft. We'd need to pin our hopes on an international flight.
I can't breathe. It's time you took a turn back there.
Oh, shit! Can't be much longer now, surely. Somebody's got to hear that signal.
They will. We've been pretty lucky up till now.
Lucky.
In what way have we been lucky?
Well, if one of us had been on deck when that wave hit, it would have been curtains.
If we cut the parachute, we would have been fine.
Hey. It was your idea to put it out in the first place. Remember that.
What's that supposed to mean? You knew the storm was coming. You put us out here. You risked our lives.
All right, ready to go.
Leaving on a journey and arriving at a destination is the best part of cruising. To be honest, I dislike blue water sailing. It bores me to tears. The excitement of bad weather and long night watches soon wears off. For me, it was all about seeing the world and taking my home with me.
There's a man who knows what he's doing.
Fair flying along, mate. She's got a great turn of speed.
Oh yeah, she's fast. Just go like the women.
So who have you left behind? You have someone in Australia?
Oh, more interested in who I could be sailing towards, mate.
Hey, who's the lady in the picture down below?
Well, that is the original Rose Noel. It's Asian princess. Named the boat after her.
Love my life. You still love her?
In spirit.
You're going a bit fast, John, don't you think? We're not that much of a bloody hurry, are we?
Well, I want to get as far as we can before nightfall.
Well, why?
Well, the weather's changing.
The weather's changing? What do you mean? What's it doing?
Well, there's a storm coming. And we're going to catch it. It'll be on us pretty soon. And then we'll do some real sailing.
A little knowledge is a dangerous thing.
I don't like this. I really don't like this.
Phil had limited coastal sailing experience. Maybe that's why he was so anxious. His fear was contagious.
How long is this gonna last?
What's the big surprise? If you guys heard the marine forecast, you would have known about this. This storm's gonna blow us all the way to Tonga in no time. You sailed us into a storm on purpose?
Get on the radio now! Fuck you! Call the Coast Guard! Get us! A helicopter, get us off! Hello, sister!
Hey! Oh, hey. Oh, well. Oh. That radio's short range. There's no one out here to hear you.
Why?
Why what?
Why is it short range?
Because I don't have a license.
Why not?
because I don't believe them. I don't want to waste the money. When you're out here, you're out here. That's the journey you're on.
Fuck you, mate. We're gonna flip.
We're not gonna flip. This yacht can't flip. I sell 40,000 miles on one of these. This is just another blow.
Yeah, when was that? 20 years ago?
I built this baby with my own hands. We've already crossed the Tasman together.
You're safe, Rick.
Relax.
What about a sea anchor? You got one of those?
What for?
What, to stop us bouncing around while we rode it out?
Yeah.
Have you got one?
Of course I have.
Well, then let's throw it out, slice down a bit.
No way. It's brand new. Cost me a lot of money. It won't do any good.
Let's take a boat.
Yeah.
It's not a bloody democracy, mate.
Hey, fuck you. Where is it?
I made one big mistake. This was it. Allowing myself to be bulldozed by a terrified crew with no experience of blue water sailing. The noise of waves smashing against a multi-hull is like gunfire. It can be terrifying if you're not used to it.
What the hell was that?
Chute must have failed.
And we gotta free it.
No, too dangerous.
It's pulling us side on.
No, you make a mistake pulling it in. You could lose a finger or a hand.
Then we cut it loose.
No. Hey! Tiller's there. All we can do is sit tight and wait it out.
We can't lead this ship like that.
I'm the skipper, Rick. Remember?
Get some sleep. Sort it in the morning when conditions improve.
Send out distress signals. Any plane flying over here will pick it up.
Money? I'm not insured. I don't believe in it. I'm insured with the gods, not the bottom feeders.
Hey, you're in my space, mate.
What happens if a wave flips the boat the right side up? We're gonna be fine with all this water.
It can't happen, okay? Won't happen.
No. We've got to cut an escape hatch.
You are not cutting another hole in this bloody boat. Now, you have some respect for her, for me, for everything I put into it.
No bloody way. This is our lives we're talking about. If you won't do it, I will.
It was painful to watch, like the violation of a loved one. But Rick was not a man to argue with. Once he made his mind up, that was it. Breaking outside didn't make them feel any better. Seeing the magnitude of what we're up against, their morale sank to a new low. Any hope of a quick rescue seemed a distant prospect. Once the EPU battery died, we were on our own. Outside standard flight paths and shipping lanes. Wind, current, and the gods were taking us for a ride. The only control we had was over ourselves.
Rick, Jim, give us a hand outside, eh?
We needed to put differences behind us and work as a team.
Give us a bloody hand, would you?
I'm busy. I don't know why you're doing that anyway. No point. No bother.
We need to make ourselves more visible to passing ships, planes, whatever, that's why.
Doing?
Take it easy, mate. I didn't mean to.
Screw you, Rick. Look, I'm bleeding.
Oh, get over it.
Jesus, you're a bloody moron.
And we ration all food from now on.
Who says?
It's the smart thing to do. We don't know how long we're going to be out here. we're going to get hold of the sails. You're going to dive for them tomorrow.
I've told you already. You can't sail this boat upside down.
And we make decisions by vote from now on. Majority rules and we stick to the rules.
You used to be a cop, didn't you? Hey, let it go, Rick. Man, your emotional body is starving in urinate. Have faith in the God within.
You can shove your dumbass religion up your skinny ass.
Rick, pass me the cabbage. Where's the knife? This one's shit. No. Ah. We got tuna. There was a lemon somewhere lying around on this leaking sieve of a boat. All right, there we are. Clear.
Me living on the sea, spirit of a sailor, circumnavigates the globe.
I just been 6 months in a leaky boat.
Lucky just to be afloat.
What song is that?
It's a Kiwi classic, mate.
No.
Aotearoa.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta get out of here.
I just spent 6 months on a leaking boat.
I think Rick felt he'd lost Jim to us, like someone had stolen his girlfriend. Or maybe something else was going on inside his head. Meanwhile, back home, Jim's girlfriend Martha was becoming concerned. By now, he should have made contact from Tonga. After 3 weeks adrift, no one had begun searching for us.
I think it still works. I haven't used it for a while.
Okay.
Not going to be able to get through anyway.
What's that, Darren? What did you say?
You're not going to be able to get through. Gordon will radio for you. You arrange a time with John.
What do you mean?
Gordon's supposed to call him and get his position, but John's not going to be able to call him or name the boat because his radio's illegal. That's the deal.
The deal?
I heard him talking about it. Gordon's going to call him and give him a weather forecast.
Well, why didn't you tell us this before? Your dad wouldn't have gone if he'd known they didn't have a proper radio.
Oh.
Hello? How do you drive this thing?
Come aboard!
So, I reckon they're out here somewhere.
Okay, let's give it a go. 6128.6. That's what John and I agreed. It's almost 8:30. You might be listening. Cargo calling Rose Noel. Do you read me? Your position, please. Over. Was that 28 degrees south? Please confirm or deny, Rose Noel. Over.
Something wasn't right. I'd filled the tanks to capacity with fresh water before we left. We had it gone. For the first time, I had doubts about our survival.
you going to check the water tanks, John? John?
Check them already.
And?
Empty.
What do you mean empty? There's no water?
Hang on. So, all the water you've been talking about in the tanks, thousands of litres, it's all gone?
What happened to it? Where's all the water gone?
Well, it must have drained out when we capsized.
It's drained out? How come?
There are air vents in the tanks.
Why don't you bloody well tell us? Well?
We need to stay calm.
Shit! You guys got to face the facts. We're going to die. And there's no point about your stupid mask or your stupid rationing. We've all had it. Fuck the lot of you.
Phil. Oh, watch out. Jesus.
Get the knife.
Get the knife back. Fuckwit. You dropped it. You get it back. Hey, shithead. I brought a present for you. Put these on and piss off. Hey, if we're all fucked, why don't you swim for it? Bye-bye, Phil.
Fuck her off. It's not my fault there's no bloody water.
Rick, stop it. Come on. Rick, you son of a bitch. Rick, stop it.
Rick, leave him alone. Okay, I'll go down and look for the sails now. I'll do it now, all right? Is that good enough for you?
Hey, well, have you suddenly changed your tune?
Because you're a dangerous man, Rick. Things go wrong, things don't go your way. You throw a wobbly. You don't trust. I'll get the sail.
No.
I'll do it.
You? Yeah, sure.
No, bad idea, Phil. I should do it. I know where they are.
Yeah, so do I. Fuck the lot of you.
What if he doesn't make it?
More of everything for the rest of us.
You're out of line, Rick. Seriously out of line.
Jesus.
Hated to lose control. Any setback could send him into a rage. He always needed someone to blame for his predicament. Usually it was me, but it could be anyone. It was only later I understood what was really driving him. He felt he was running out of time. It was a sign. I knew we were being looked after.
I have told you, mate, there's no fish out here. Nothing lives this far from land.
Hey, maybe we can have a water ration now.
Nope. Still no sign of rain. Hey, guys. Check this out. I've been thinking. Can we capsize? We would have been about here. Prevailing current is going that way. Take us maybe 10, 20 miles a day. So, after 34 days drifting, that would put us right off the map.
But there's nothing there. Nothing until South America. That's gonna take us
at least 8 months. Possibly. Or the current could take us north along the line of the continent, but well out of sight of land. And that would add another 1,000 miles.
1,000 miles.
Yeah. Just you wait. Your bikes are gonna be famous.
What the fuck are you doing? You writing your memoirs?
Haven't made my mind up yet. Might be a book. Might be a lovely letter to my ex.
Who? Rose Noel. The poor bitch you named this piece of crap after. Why'd she dump you anyway?
She didn't dump me. She died in a plane crash. Pan Am 816. She's on the way to join me.
Oh, yeah.
But there's been many women since my sweet Rose Noel. Too many.
Sure, I mean, you're a real catch. Hmm? Sane, handsome, young, normal, sane, sane!
Rick, let's play a game.
Sure, why not?
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'll play the winner.
Piss off!
You gotta take it easy on him. I know he's annoying, but...
But nothing. Help me sit up.
Phil, are you going to tell him or shall I?
What?
You should do that outside.
It's too windy.
Phil lost the rod.
That was the only rig we had. First the only decent bloody knife and now the rod. How bloody thick are you?
I'm sorry, okay?
No, not okay. It's everything else about you. You're a greedy, farting pig. Look at your head, mate. You look like you've been in a fight. When are you going to learn how low the fucking roof is?
I just want to go home.
Phil, it's okay. It's okay.
Thank you.
guys, check this out. Something I've been working on. It's a collection system for water. These are PVC pipes. I got heaps of them in the starboard pontoon. What do you think?
I don't see how you... How are you going to cut the pipes?
Exactly. Look, how about... Why don't we use the surface of the hull as a catchment and we put wood along here and over here with drain holes here and here.
Yeah, good on you, mate. Hey, now you're pulling your weight. Hey?
Yeah. So have we got any wood?
You can survive a long time without food, but not without water. Over the weeks, we had reduced our rations to little more than 2 ounces of liquid each per day.
It's been a bloody work.
But now the precious water was almost gone. We were beyond thirst, suffering the onset of dehydration.
Ray, what's that?
It's a yacht.
It's the beacon! Quick, get the beacon!
Come on! Quick!
Yeah. Guys, it's too far out. They'll never see it.
Generator fuel.
Oh, good on you, mate. Brilliant. Okay, stand back. Yeah, check it out. Come on.
Forget it. It's gone. Yeah, a yacht like that should be out here. It's a sign.
Yeah, so we're not as close to South America as you thought.
No, it's a sign from God. We're going to be okay.
Enough! Okay, no more! You give me a fucking headache!
Everything in life happens for a reason. That yacht is a sign. We willed her to appear.
Yeah. Just like you willed that storm to appear, eh? You fucking wanker!
God only knows what you know. Don't you know that? Everything comes from within, don't fight it.
One more word. I swear, one more word and I will fucking gag you!
Rick.
Yeah. Thank you, God, for bringing us this far, and thank you for what is to come.
There is still no contact with the missing crew of the Rose Noel, which left Picton on June the 6th with 4 local men on board. The trimaran was expected to arrive in Tonga by the middle of the month. It is now 6 weeks overdue. Following an unsuccessful search by RNZAF Orion, pressure is now mounting for a second search, despite the already considerable expenditure of public money.
Thank you.
It's raining! Water! It's raining!
Get the bottles!
On their way.
Home?
Does Rick have a white cable knit jersey?
No.
I see him in one. Very nice. And gumboots. On an island.
Which island?
I've asked the guides, but they won't tell me. The name is two words, five letters and seven letters. Rick's guide is here with us now. He's standing right behind you. He's telling us they're safe.
He'll be back. Yeah, don't worry. He'll be back.
I think I got some.
Oh, this is perfect.
Yeah. And this?
Okay. Excellent.
We good?
Yeah, we're good. That's all we need.
Of mates just like you.
No fish in the sea, eh, John?
There will be now. They'll be coming for the bunkers in the hull.
When are you going to check those gas tanks, John?
There's no telling how far they've corroded. My mistake, blast all the bits. Come on. Let's just appreciate what we've got. We don't give thanks enough. Thank you, God, for sending us Harry.
And please help John find his inner what have you so that we can use the bloody gas tanks. Amen.
Oh, amen.
Harry's friends had begun to appear in numbers. After 2.5 months at sea, the Rose Noel had become a floating reef. Our menu was expanding. Barnacle, seaweed, and kingfish. Plenty of kingfish.
Oi! Imagine that fried.
I'm not gonna give up on the gas tanks, John. You find them. Or I will. You wouldn't like that. I might hurt your precious bloody boat.
All right!
Okay, Jim, turn it on.
Cat's coming. Shouldn't you be on your knees, John? Praying?
Yeah, he's gonna get the big one.
They're all roughly the same size.
Pig's ass.
It's your birthday, am I right, Rick? You have first choice.
Don't worry, Phil. You can have the biggest mate. Cheers.
Bloody beautiful.
Hollow victory, isn't it? Could have hit this months ago.
He knew exactly where those tanks were. We didn't have to wait for this time to have hot bloody food. We have to fight for everything. It's like we're not suffering enough for him.
It's true, mate. It's true.
Every idea we have, he scoffs at. He uses knowledge of the boat to build a power over us.
Hey, the most important thing is we got gas now, not food. How good's that?
Him starting to sound like him. Like he went there.
What the hell's wrong with you? He's the one that got this whole thing rigged up. Just be thankful.
Fuck you! Hey, why are you defending him now, eh? Sad shit! You pussy with a fucking yank! Hey! Hey! Guys! Jesus!
Wait!
Despite our improving situation, Rick's moods were becoming darker, more erratic. Not even Jim was safe from his fits of temper.
Yes! Oh, he got
Come on!
I got it!
Get
going, George!
Come on!
Albatross burritos and a tomato puree. Delicious.
You're a bloody artist, Jim.
What's supposed to happen if you kill an albatross?
The Ancient Mariner was doomed to wander the ocean forever.
The Ancient Mariner didn't fry his, so I think we get a pass.
So much food, we could have people over. Happy birthday, mate.
Nice one, Rick. Keep you warm on watch.
For he's a jolly good fellow.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us.
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
What's up, man? You right?
Couldn't have had a better birthday.
Doesn't make sense to be happy out here.
Most of us gathered here have sailed the South Pacific, and most of us know John Glennie. So far, our requests to mount another search have been fruitless. So it may be that we have to find the money ourselves. Some $15,000 per hour of flying time. Does anybody recall anything that he might have said about the route?
Yeah, can you tell us if you definitely heard John's voice when you took the position?
The speaker never identified himself.
But you clearly heard Rose Noel.
I think so. Oh,
thanks. You're full of shit.
Martha, please.
It is only because of your lies that they searched the Kermadex.
That was John's fourth waypoint. It made sense to look for them there.
Bullshit.
Karen was there, she'll tell you.
There was so much interference, we could hardly hear anything.
We know nothing, that's the bloody truth.
What we want is to search from this line 300 miles to the east.
Funded by friends and family, another search has been mounted for the trimaran Rose Noel, missing at sea now for nearly 3 months.
20 minutes of flying time in this direction before we turn around. 130 degrees to the south.
It had taken nearly 3 months, but finally we were beginning to work as a team. Each of us had a role. We had food and water. We could have gone on forever.
Farewell and adieu to you fine Spanish ladies. Farewell and adieu to you ladies of Spain. We've received orders to send for old England. Perhaps nevermore shall we see you again.
Farewell and adieu, my fair Spanish ladies. Farewell and adieu, all you ladies of Spain.
You think maybe we'll need a bigger boat?
There was no point in telling the others. The ship was too far off to see us. It was better to spare them the disappointment.
Get out here!
What's up, mate?
Tell
on me.
Christ, you bastards! It's land!
Fix your eyes, John, you son of a bitch! I reckon we're about 10 miles out. John? You okay? John! Look at it! Man, it's real, mate!
I couldn't find words to describe how I felt. Relief, elation, disappointment. I just knew it was coming to an end. Whatever that meant. Perhaps that was what I was afraid of. I didn't know. The others were looking forward to lives they could return to. But my life was here, with what was left of my ruined Rose Noel. I had nowhere else to go.
You know, we should have the record by now.
Record?
What record? 119 days and an over 2 buck. Got me some kind of record.
Jesus, Johnny, gives a toss.
I told you, you blokes are going to be famous.
Let's concentrate on getting on land first.
Yeah, I just want to get back to Karen and the kids. That'll do me.
What? What can't be?
When I was a kid, we used to go on holiday on the Great Barrier Island. See that peak?
Yeah.
That looks like you're Okimata. The mountain on the barrier. Well, all mountains look pretty much the same from a distance. I worked it out. It must be an island off South America.
Hirakimata, Mount Hobson. I reckon that's it.
Well, how could that be possible? We've drifted thousands of miles in the other direction.
You might be wrong.
Making landfall is always dangerous. The ocean striking a landmass can produce a short, confused seaway. Conflicting wind and currents draw you in like a magnet.
John, Christ's sake, put it on. There's no need. No more bullshit. Put the bloody thing on.
We could almost touch the land, but having no way of steering Rose Noel, we were in danger of being cast onto the rocks.
What was that?
Must be the mast. Hitting the seabed.
If the mast were driven up through the hull, Rose Noel could break apart and throw us into the sea.
We've got to get off the boat.
We'll be all right, guys. We're being looked after.
Fuck, Bill, I'm going to swim for
it. I'm with you, mate.
Too dangerous, mate. Stay with her, you'll be fine.
Exhausted, but apart from a blow to the head and a twisted knee, I was okay. In the end, after months of constant danger, enduring storm and tempest, we just drifted gently to shore. When Rose Noel could take us no further, we slipped into the water and waded to dry land.
What are you doing, John? Praying?
You blokes didn't have to worry. We're always going to make it. We should give thanks.
We'll just be thankful we made it. Mate, eh? That's enough.
Of course we do. What'd I tell you?
Dry land. Beautiful. We're never in any danger. No one's. Thanks to you. What about the sail bag? Can you see it?
John, we're off, mate.
John, tell me that's not a Pohutukawa tree. Toi Toi.
Definitely in New Zealand.
This way, guys. Looks like a track.
Break a window?
No, there'll be a key. There's always a key.
Not connected.
I must have been in shock. Inside a real house after so long.
Still think we're in South America, mate?
I couldn't join the party. Feeding frenzy. All I could think of was my poor Rose Noel drifting helpless in the bay. I wanted to return to her, but I didn't have the strength.
Up there, mate.
Oh, thank you, mate. Cheers.
Good job there, buddy.
Sharp scissors.
Need a hand?
No. I'm good. I'm really good. Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Look at this place. This house, we are four bloody lucky guys.
Yes, we are. A toast. Tomorrow, with any luck, we find a phone and we get off this island. very unlikely the four of us will ever be alone again. Well, not like this. John, I want to thank you for getting us through this. It's because of you, the Rose Noel was a bountiful mother to us all. To John.
I don't know why you were so certain that we were going to be saved. And please spare us any more of your crackpot theories, but although it's hard to admit, I guess you were right in the end.
Yes.
But I love you guys, and I hope that after all we've been through, we can remain friends. Famous friends. They'll give us all medals.
Yeah, the friends.
Oh, pudding. Can't sleep. How's your head?
It hurts.
Can I help you, blokes? Who the hell are you? Now, what are you doing in Jim's house?
Where are we?
What do you mean? Great Barrier Island? Hey, what's going on here? Who are you?
We're the crew from the Rose Noel.
That trimaring that we're missing.
That's right.
Nah. You guys are supposed to be dead.
Really good to see you.
A few hundred meters either side of that cove. I would have been filling out a report on four dead bodies.
No chance.
Yeah, mate.
Hello.
Hi, can I speak to Heather, please?
Speaking. Rick?
Yeah.
Rick?
It's me. Sorry, love, didn't recognize you.
Are you there?
Oh, God, sorry, yes. Oh, darling. I don't believe it's true, it's really you.
Yeah, it's me. Look, we're on Great Barrier Island. Can I, you and Maddie?
Yes, I will. Oh, darling, I love you. Maddie, it's Billy. Yeah. Oh, darling.
Oh. See you soon, okay?
Port of departure.
Perfect.
Date of capsize.
Hello?
Martha. It's me.
Are you there?
Yes, of course I am.
You're flying us to Auckland. Can you please get on a plane and meet me there? Please, Martha.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.
What's the first? Okay, you mentioned sightings of a freight.
Hey. Hey, Sneaky Poo. It's Snugglebeard.
Hi, babe. Jeez, I missed you. Yeah, I know. I've really missed you.
Yeah, well, you should get a plane. You get a plane to Auckland as soon as you can. Yeah.
Turn.
No.
Did you have any doubts that you'd make it?
Not one.
Why is that?
Faith. Abiding faith.
Mr. Glennie, I presume?
Yeah.
Ross Lang, Marine Transport Division. This is Captain McKinley. Mind if we ask you a few questions?
No.
Did you keep a logbook, Mr. Glennie?
Yeah.
Any idea where it is now?
This was so unexpected.
Are you serious? Christ, can't this wait?
If you want us to believe your story, Mr. Glennie, you'd better cooperate.
After all we'd been through.
What did you do for food and water all the time you were supposedly adrift?
Rick? Rick, darling,
I struggled to comprehend how we could have survived so much and yet be treated with such suspicion.
Well, I don't know what these men have been doing for 119 days, but they haven't been drifting on the ocean.
And it was only the beginning. We had no inkling of what we were about to walk into. No one would believe us.
Damn it! Maddie, please.
Many people are wondering what power and spirit they had. These four men who spent July, August, and September
Ministry
adrift.
Ministry of Transport officials are to retrace the 119-day voyage of the Rose Noel with the use of a computer.
Not too good to be true. With no salt sores, far too well fed. What do they eat out there all the time?
Who do they think they're kidding? Bloody crack smuggling, I reckon. They're having us on, and it's all bullshit.
I don't believe a word of it. How are they floating around for so long without someone seeing them? Just impossible. It's just...
On the yacht, you okay, mate? It's just not humanly possible. I know what conditions are like that time of year. No yacht's going to stay afloat for even half that time, mate.
Amid the euphoria, relief, and sheer joy at the survival of the crew, some serious questions arise. The Transport Minister has asked for a preliminary investigation into the crew members' claims of the 120-day ordeal, which has attracted widespread scepticism.
So what do you say, John, in response to those who don't believe you? Is there an alternative story?
You know, I couldn't give a stuff what anybody thinks.
Jim, check it out. John's on the telly.
We were adrift all that time, survived only because we were careful, clever, and looked out for each other. For the rest of my life, I'll be grateful to Phil, and Rick and Jim. Circumstances that were the best men I could have hoped for. If you're watching this, guys, I thank you.
We needed a miracle and we got one. Skipper John Glennie claims his yacht was capsized by a huge wave 3 days into their voyage. But now, after surviving 119 days drifting at sea, the Rose Noel broke up in a storm yesterday.
Mr. Glennie,
Danny returned to the wreck by helicopter, accompanied by Marine Division investigators who were trying to piece together the final voyage of the Rose Noel.
Don't have a look at this. I might have been wrong.
It's perhaps New Zealand's most miraculous survival story ever. How four men and an upturned boat could drift on the high seas without trace for nearly 4 months and live to tell the story. So remarkable was their tale of survival that some began to doubt that it ever happened. But a report released today backs up the incredible saga.
This inquiry, with detailed scientific evidence supporting it, has demonstrated that this is absolutely true and in fact is one of the great stories of human survival on the seas.
Rose Noel's skipper, John Glennie, describes the report as fair and thorough. Glennie says it answers the doubts some people had.
Sadly, 8 months after our return, Rick died of a brain tumour. Jim helped take care of him and then trained as a nurse. Phil went back to sea. He even made several voyages across the Pacific and fathered another child. But despite the ordeal, we had survived so well together. After we left the island, I never saw Rick, Jim, or Phil ever again.